Good morning, children. Today we will revise chapter number 2. Okay, chapter number 2, that is components of food. Okay, children. So, children, I already explained this chapter. We are just to go through this chapter once again. Okay. So, here what are the components of the food? That means the chemical substances present in the food. They are known as the nutrients. Okay. They are known as the nutrients. And what are the different nutrients present? That only the components. The different nutrients are the carbohydrate, then proteins, fats, then vitamins and minerals, then this much. Okay, along with this we will do this one also. What? Water and their roughage. Clear, children? So these are the nutrients. Okay, carbohydrates, they are the energy giving food. Okay, then the proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, and then not only that, along with these nutrients, water and roughage also present. Okay, so now I will explain each one separately. Okay, so here how this one, see, carbohydrates. If I talk about carbohydrates, first one is carbohydrate. See, carbohydrates, they are what? They are the energy giving food. Energy giving food. Okay, so here see, energy, this carbohydrates, the major form of the carbohydrates are sugar, then starch, then cellulose. Okay, sugar and starch the human beings can digest, but cellulose, it is actually a plant carbohydrate. Okay, the carbohydrate present in plant in the form of cellulose. Okay, here this cellulose, actually we can't digest this. Herbivorous animals. Herbivorous animals are eating the plant product, plants, right? So this plants contains this cellulose, and which is not able to digest easily. And then this herbivorous animals are having the special stomach, right? The different stomachs, like there's a rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum, like this, right? So in that there is rumen, this is special stomach in the herbivorous animals. That here, that special enzyme secreted, and because of that the cellulose will be digested easily. Understood? Now these two are the that means they are, plants are also getting this. Not only that, the human beings can easily digest this. This is the sources, okay, forms, major forms of carbohydrates. And now when I talk about this one, the sources, when we see sources, sugar, then this one potato, then this one, what I can say, cereals, all the cereals like rice, wheat, these contains carbohydrates. Okay, and this carbohydrates, so who need it? Requirement. If I talk about the requirement, most mainly this carbohydrates need the one who is doing much physical work. The laborers, they are doing much heavy works, right? So they need carbohydrates because it gives more energy. And then the sports person, see, children, here in this when we talk about this banana is also a source of carbohydrates. Sports person, when we talk about this, some of the athletics, in between they are having the habit of eating the bananas. Why? That is for getting the energy in their body. Okay, that then nursing women means one who feed their babies. And then the pregnant ladies, they need the carbohydrates more. Okay, and if I say this, more, if carbohydrates taking more, then what happens? It causes obesity. Okay, obesity means that body weight will be increased, and such a person will be lethargic and tiredness, they can't do the work actively. Okay, and then if they are having that means the deficiency less taken of carbohydrates, then they will get that body weight will be reduced. Okay, understood this one? Carbohydrates. The next one is the proteins. I will explain about the proteins. Proteins. Okay, now and see children, here carbohydrates test it is there. Okay, now one test is there for carbohydrate. How can you test the carbohydrates? By see, take the potato and then this potato, if you are the slices, if you cut the slice, one slice, and then pour iodine solution. Okay, what iodine solution if you pour here, then that potato changes into blue black color. How it will changes? Blue black color it comes means that is the presence of the carbohydrate. Clear? So now that is the second one is the proteins. Proteins, if I say about proteins, proteins, they are what? They are the body builders. Our body organs like this nails, then muscles, hair, all these are made up of proteins. Okay, and this need for the repairment, if the our body cells are damaged, then for its repairment the protein required. Okay, and then this protein, actually they are the sources. If we say about the sources, they are getting like carbohydrates here also from two sources they are getting. Okay, that is the plant sources and as well as the animal sources. In the plant sources, if we say about pulses, okay, pulses, then this nuts, soya bean, from here this gets. And then if I talk about animals, then this we can say that milk, cheese, they contains this one, and butter. Okay, all these contains what? Then fish, egg, all these are the animal sources of the fat. Clear children? Now the fat, if we that who needs requirements, if we talk about proteins required, the you people, the small children need more protein. And then the that means this if we are not taking much protein, what happens? That body growth will be reduced and mental retardation will be there. Now children, see, for the test, okay, test of protein in a food sample, how we will come to know? For that, actually we have to take that means in a test tube we have to take the white portion of the egg. Okay, white portion of egg we have to add, then water. Okay, then water. Then afterwards we have to keep a add this one water, copper sulfate. Okay, copper sulfate plus caustic soda. If all these things we are adding it and just keep it shake it well and then keep it aside, then after sometimes you can see this portion it changes into violet color. Okay, violet color, it means there is the presence of protein. Okay, that contain the food sample contain proteins. Okay, and the next one is the fat. Fat, see, they are the energy bankers. Okay, energy bank, because it gives more energy, it gives double energy than the carbohydrates. Okay, then here this fat also the same way, fat also contains the, that means the sources, if we say, they are also having the this one, plant sources as well as animal sources. Okay, plant sources as well as animal sources. And if we say about the plant sources, from the plant sources, how we will get the fat? Oils. Okay, oils, different types of oils, like this groundnut oil, soya bean oil, then peanut, that only groundnut, that one, then coconut oil. So these are different kinds of, so this mustard oil, all these oils contains plant fat. Okay, this plant sources, from this plant itself we are getting the fat in the form of oil. Okay, and then even not only this, some of the nuts, if we say that also gives fat. And here animal sources, if I say that, then butter, ghee, they contains fat. Okay, understood children? That means that both the from the plant as well as from the animal sources, we get the fat. And the function, why fat required, little amount, small amount we need the fat in our body. Actually, this fat gives, that means energy, right? So it not only that, it keeps our body warm. Okay, and they are then shock absorbers also. Okay, and it prevent us from injuries. Okay, therefore that fat helps. And then this the same way, the one who is doing the physical work more, and then the nursing women, pregnant ladies, small children, they need more fat. And then if we take more fat, then what happens? It causes obesity. Okay, obesity, that means increase our body weight. And if we are not taking, that means in less amount in our body, then what happens? This fat, that actually it gives that tiredness, the same way. And if we are taking, intake of more fat causes the heart diseases. Okay, so heart diseases, it occurs because of fat. Clear, understood? Now how we will test this fat? For testing of the fat, we have to take a paper. Okay, what we have to take a paper, that should be, you just keep that paper under the light, then it should not allow the light to pass. That means actually paper, it is opaque, right? So then you apply a few, that means butter here. Okay, some butter apply here, and then rub it. Then you keep this paper under the light. Then you can see that it allow the light to pass through. That means that paper becomes translucent. Okay, it means it contains fat. That this way we can check the test of fat. Clear? Now the next one is the vitamins and minerals. Okay, which one? Vitamins and minerals. If I talk about vitamins. Vitamins, actually vitamins are very important in our body. They protect us from the diseases, so they are known as the protective food. Okay, then vitamins, actually vitamins, two types of vitamins, they are water soluble vitamin and fat soluble vitamin. Okay, water soluble and fat soluble vitamins. And here if you say about water soluble vitamins, what are the vitamins? Vitamin B complex. Okay, vitamin B complex. Vitamin B complex means they contains vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12. These all are the what? B complex. Plus vitamin C. These are water soluble vitamins. And if I say about the fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E and K. These are the different vitamins. And vitamins in small amount only we need it. If they are not taking the proper amount of vitamins, not getting the proper amount of vitamins in our body, what happens? Then we will get some deficiency diseases. And all these vitamins, they are having different functions. They all are working, that means our body, different organs need, for different functions we need the different types of vitamins. Clear children? Now I will explain about the minerals. Okay. Minerals. If I talk about minerals, what are the minerals required in our body? The minerals like calcium, very very essential, right, for our teeth and as well as our bones. Calcium. Then iron. Iron is for the formation of the blood. Iron is very very important. Then sodium for this one. We can say that if there is less sodium, then we will get a tiredness. Then the iodine. Iodine also very very important. If there is no iodine in our body, then it gets the that means thyroid problems. Okay. Then goiter. It causes goiter. That goiter means protruding our neck from this side. Okay. That is the goiter. Then potassium. All these are the what? These all are the minerals. They all are having different functions they need in our body. Okay, for different functions. Now the except these minerals, this now understood. Vitamins and minerals are the protective food. Now this one water. For talk about water. Water that is also be very important for in our body for the proper functioning. Okay, digest for the digestion of the food it helps. And then for the movement, that means that circulation of the blood. Okay, transportation of the water and blood. For that also water is required. And water for at least 8. Minimum 8 glasses of water we have to drink per day. Okay. And then not only that, as the simple way we have to take the water in the form of juices and in the this vegetables like onion, they also contains much water in it. Okay. And then the fruits that also contains the water. So all these in these forms also we can take water. Okay. Then if I say this one, roughage. The next one is the roughage. Roughage means what it is, children? It is the fiber. It is the fiber present in the food. Okay. So this roughage is also, though it is not a that means a nutrient of the food, but it is very very important for our body. Okay, so it helps for the proper functioning of our digestive system. It helps to remove the undigested food from the body. Okay, if we are not taking enough fiber food in our body, then it causes constipation. Okay, what it causes? Constipation. Okay, the stool becomes hard. It will not allow to pass it easily. That is understood this water and roughage. And if all these nutrients present in proper, that means in right amount, then what it is said, that diet is said to be balanced diet. It is said to be balanced diet. And the children, this balanced diet, is it same for all person? No, it is not. It depends upon the age of the person, then the gender, whether that it depends. That means male and female, they are getting different diet they require. Okay, gender and the type of work they do, type of work. So for depending these things, this diet will be different. Okay. So according to that, we have to take the diet. And see, this if this balanced diet, the diet, if we are not taking the proper amount of diet, what happens? It causes malnutrition. What it causes? Malnutrition. Malnutrition means that intake of less food, okay, less nutrients, then it will get a malnutrition. And malnutrition, why it is happy? It is also because of the two things. Malnutrition, that is, one is it is a if the taking of excess amount, then it is known as the overnutrition. What it is? Overnutrition. If we are taking more amount, that is also be not good for our health. Okay. And one is undernourishment. One is under nourishment. Nourishment. Okay, over nutrition causes what? It causes mainly obesity. It is not good for our health. And but undernourishment is also not good. Undernourishment, then what it causes? It causes deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases. Now deficiency, if I say about this deficiency, understood malnutrition, that is because of the overnutrition as well as undernutrition. Now if I say about the undernourishment, the deficiency diseases, the deficiency, if we are not taking proper amount of food, then we will get the diseases. They are known as deficiency disease of lack of some nutrients. Because of the lack of some nutrients, we will get a deficiency diseases. And mainly, see, if there is a that means if we are not taking enough protein in our body, then because of the lack of protein, which diseases comes? That is kwashiorkor. Kwashiorkor. Okay, here in this kwashiorkor, what happens? That stomach becomes swollen and legs becomes thin. Leg thin, but stomach protruded, swollen. Okay, that is because of the kwashiorkor. And now we talk about carbohydrates, then fats. Carbohydrates and fat, then that causes marasmus. Marasmus. Okay, we can say this as a PEM. PEM. PEM means protein mal. This a PEM. Okay. If the marasmus, in this marasmus, what happens? The body becomes thin, and then thin. As well as the ribs, you can see the ribs on the bodies, and the skin becomes a loose skin. Okay, skin becomes loose. Understood? So this only what this today's chapter. That means I hope you all understood this chapter well. If please children read the chapter again and again, and if you are not able to understand again, just go through the video and listen it carefully. Okay children, take care.